Hey guys, what's up? I'm Miranda from REI. Sleeping bag temperature ratings are a great way to get an apples to apples comparison of different sleeping bags. But what do these numbers mean and how do we arrive at them? Let's talk about ISO standardized testing and how sleeping bags are tested and rated. When you're looking at sleeping bags, you'll often see an ISO temperature rating. What this means is that the bag manufacturer has paid for the International Standards Organization, or ISO, to test the sleeping bag. This test is conducted in a temperature-controlled room with a test dummy that's covered in heat sensors. And this test dummy is wearing a base layer top, base layer bottom, as well as a hat and socks. And they're testing it on a winter weight sleeping pad. The sleeping pad, as well as the apparel the test dummy is wearing and the temperature in the room, is standardized for all ISO testing. After these tests are finished, ISO comes up with two different numbers. The first one, or the higher number, is the ISO comfort rating. This number is the lowest temperature at which the average cold sleeper will be comfortable in the bag. The second number, or the lower number, is the lowest temperature at which the average warm sleeper will be comfortable in the bag. You'll often see these referred to as the women's temperature rating for the warmer temperature and the men's temperature rating for the colder temperature. This is just because women in general will sleep colder than men. One thing to keep in mind is that a women's bag that's rated for 15 degrees is going to be slightly heavier than a men's bag that's rated for 15 degrees. And this is just because the difference in how women sleep. And also because that women's bag is using the comfort rating, whereas the men's bag is using that lower limit rating from the ISO testing. If you are a cold sleeper, you might be inclined to go with a women's bag regardless of your gender identity, but keep your body type in mind as the bags also have different construction and empty spaces within the bag or spaces that are too tight are also going to affect how warm it is. While the ISO standardization is great, there are some limitations to the test. The first thing is that they do use a winter weight sleeping pad, something like this one, which has an R value of 5.7. You may not use something like this. You might use something more like this, which has an R value of 2. So keep that in mind when you're looking at the temperature ratings, as your sleeping pad does make a huge difference in the warmth of your sleeping bag. The other thing is that you might be sleeping in base layers that are warmer or not as warm as the test dummy in the ISO test. If you're sleeping in your skivvies, you're definitely not going to be as warm in your sleeping bag as they are when you're there testing the bags. Another thing is that not all manufacturers are going to pay for the ISO testing, so you might see on some casual sleeping bags that they don't have an ISO temperature rating just because they're not necessarily predicting that people are going to use that bag in extreme conditions. Speaking of extremes, if you are looking for a bag for extreme cold, unfortunately, ISO testing doesn't test bags that are below 0 degrees. So again, keep that in mind when you're shopping for your sleeping bags. The last thing is that while the ISO standards are good for averages, the temperature that you are in your bag is going to vary greatly depending on whether you're a warm or cold sleeper, or if you've eaten a lot of food, or if you haven't eaten enough. So again, these are just there to give you a good idea of how the temperatures on the bags work. That's it for how ISO standardization and sleeping bag temperature ratings work. If you want more information on this, or if you're looking for how to sleep better and sleep warmer, I made an entire other video on that, and you can check that out as well. And of course, it's a good idea to come in and look at sleeping bags, test them out, take them for a trial nap. So come into your local REI and talk to the experts or test out bags there. See you later.